Hello world and welcome back to another episode of Post Finem. So we've got processed another update here. I don't know what's changed in the pack. Our lava is still definitely broken. It's still going to cost us a million RF to make a single bucket of lava. You'll notice a roof here and stylized, well, finished the walls and stuff. Because I wanted to get ready and I don't have a way to get up here yet, aside from the pistons on my boots. We're going to go ahead and I think get into Railcraft this episode. I've got this guy up here, which is probably not the best location for it yet because I don't have any resources up here. But more importantly, I've gone ahead and set up a rail line to our, well, not a rail line, but where we're going to put our rail line. Going over to our tree farm. So, yeah, I think we're ready to go. We just got to make the stuff. Now, the question is, do I have enough rail ties that I've looted to actually do this or not? And I don't know the answer to that question. We can make some tracks. Now, I think what I want to use is the reinforced tracks. Yeah, this one. But this shows you all the recipes for all the tracks. It doesn't actually just show you the reinforced recipe. I don't. Maybe we don't even need the wooden ties anymore. We need stone ties. We need rhubarb. Okay, so I don't think we actually need creosote oil to make the reinforced tracks. We actually want to be down here. We want to grab some steel and get going on this. So let's see. I made up a bunch of steel because I figured we were going to need it, and this is going to get annoying quick. Maybe I should just pull that back down here for the time being. Eventually I'll want all my railcraft stuff up here, I think, but this is going to go quicker if it's down in my little workshop there, my janitor closet. I went ahead and made up that item turret, set it over there. I don't know what it does, but it's just over there as decoration. So, I also did notice that the quest book was updated a little bit. If you come in here and you go to civilization, there's now this stuff. So it looks like you can actually create a town using millionaire, which is a mod I haven't played with since 1.6, so it's that'll be interesting. So we have these wood ties. I don't think we need it. I did make up the stuff for a coke oven because I have some thoughts on that. We'll have the incoming charcoal decompose into carbon, get resynthesized into coal, fed into the coal coke ovens, and then we'll have coal coke and creosote, and then we can use the coal coke to burn in our power gen. So it's an idea, but let's make some stuff. We got my rolling machine. Is there? Yeah, good. There's some power. All right, so we want to make some rhubarb, I guess. Let's make. I don't know. We're gonna need a lot of this stuff, I think, for making the actual train. We don't need. Let's just do this, I guess. Oh, hey, that's pretty cool. All right, so that's gonna make up. So we're gonna, in addition to that, we're going to need an actual steam locomotive or something. Yeah, this guy. This is gonna require solid fuel boilers, which I think we can do. Mine carts, iron bars, and high pressure boiler plates. So it looks like we can do all that. We're going to need some clay bricks, and since we have clay, we shouldn't have a problem with that. So furnace only. Let's get that going. Looks like we got our rhubarb. Okay, so now turning that into reinforced rail. Wait, what? Oh, that's right. It's a stone rail bed. So it's stone ties, stone slabs. Okay. Well, we got plenty of stone. Let's see. I didn't leave this on, did I? I did. We are backed up on copper. We are backed up. Oh, I severed the power up to there, somehow. Okay. Let's get that going because that's kind of important. Let's run across here. Okay, so that's getting power. That's going. All right, so that's gonna have to correct itself. I did turn, yeah, turn that off. That's good. Okay. Anyway, back to what we were doing. We've got the stone, so let's make some stone plates. Oh, there were some in here already. Let's just, there we go. Probably need more, but for now, that's good. Where's that rhubarb? Oh, it's in my inventory. I don't know what else we need rhubarb for, but let's use that. Now we can do, what was it? Yeah. So we can make a few, I guess. Now we do need reinforced rails, which is, and luckily I made up some of that also. And obsidian dust is right here. Okay. I even put it in a nice easy spot that apparently isn't actually nice and easy. So this is actually going to make what? Two sets of rails. Let's go like this. And I should probably get some more steel going. I even still have the recipe set up here. I just need more iron, I guess. So let's get more iron going. All right, so we have that. Now to make it. Now I'm hoping we don't need like all kinds of like powered rails and stuff if we're actually using a steam locomotive. So, yeah, that'll make plenty of track actually. Now I want to be careful because I think I need some Y tracks. Because of the way I have it set up, I have two rails merging into one, and we'll have to get more complex later on. But okay, so it's a bunch of that's a switch track. We want a Y track, okay. We possibly can do that. And I think this is what I want. I'm not 100% certain because I haven't really messed around with railcraft enough to know that stuff. So it's going to be kind of a trial and error thing, but hopefully we'll get where we're going. So basically, we're going to have the cart go up one direction and come back down the other and just kind of create a loop at both sides. Now, did I make, yeah, I made the crowbar. Okay, I can't rotate it. That's annoying. No, that's not the way I want it. I want it the other way. Let's try. Okay, I'm a little unsure as to how that's supposed to be placed. Let's go. No. Aha! So theoretically, if I see this track right, so this is going to go that way, because if you see how the track overlays, the wheels are going to go that way, and then it's coming this way, it's going that way, and then this one will direct it that way as well, theoretically. So hopefully I'm right. We probably are going to need more track. Why does this not look right? Something's uneven. I don't like it. I don't like it when things are uneven. Nope, it's even. Okay, then, crisis averted. That's right. Railcraft. Okay. So what we're gonna have to do is bring this one up one more. No, we can't do that. We have to do this. Wait. What? Why is that? Ooh, look at that. Oh, it made it nice and smooth. Oh, I like that. That is cool. I didn't know that. Oh, this looks so much better now. I'm like, oh, there's going to be that gap. You know how trains are. Well, no. There's no gap. Okay. I can get behind that. So let's see. I know I'm too excited. But that is pretty cool. And then we need to, I'm gonna have to go back and put some stone here, fix that up. Okay, so theoretically that should get us up there and back. Hey, wait a minute. Why aren't you doing that? Oh, it's not a slope. Oh, it must have some special integration with carpenter's blocks. Oh, okay, well I'll have to fix that too. Cool. All right, so actually we wanted to be down there because we're going to need some a mine cart, and basically we'll just shove him down here and see, make sure he gets out to the right track there. I think I have a mine cart, or is that just mean, they're not too expensive to make. Okay, we'll keep the chest carts. We'll want those anyway. So iron ingots. Let's grab a cart. And we're gonna need two for the engine, so let's make two. Just right now. Okay, let's get rid of that overlay. Now, if everything works right, what should happen is the cart should come down here and end up pointing towards where we want it to go. Let's just lay out some more track here. Hopefully, I mean, hopefully we don't. I don't have to do any like detectors and switching and things. We might need to coming back, but I'm not sure on that. So if we put him here, let's see. Ah! Yeah. Okay. That's exactly what we want to happen. Now, if we go on to the other side, let's do this. Is it going to roll a specific direction each time? Okay, so yeah, it looks like it'll always go to that direction, which is what we want. I don't know if you can switch that to go the other way, 'cause I don't know. Coming in on the left and going out on the right seems like, I don't know. Maybe that's just being too picky. Yeah. All right. So the Y track is exactly what we wanted. All right. So things are looking up. Let's burn through this, and we're going to need apparently a lot more. Whoops, that's my Y track. And we'll set that up once we get over there. I'm thinking maybe another couple stacks would do us. Let's see. Ah, triple jump, I like it. All right, so what do we need for some more tracks? We need more steel. I have more steel. So let's see. Man, that's. I'm gonna have to hook up some better conduits. Oh, wow, hey. Ah, when it went back and filled up all these, it drained my power. That's what's going on. That needs to reboot. How many carbon? We have 30 carbon nanotubes. That's pretty good. I think that's like what, 10 diamonds, but that's good enough. Well, let's see. Can we make a few more? Well, there's another stack. Let's see how far that gets us. And we gotta get some power coming in. I took a look at big reactors. I actually have most of the components I need. And that would be well and good, but this piece. Oh, there's a recipe now. Ah, that must have been what the last update was. Hey, we could actually make a big reactor's controller, but I'm kind of interested in this whole railcraft thing, so I think we're going to continue on with this, and maybe next episode we'll do some big reactors. Oh, we almost have enough. And bam. Almost have enough. We don't actually have enough. Oh, yep, there we go. We ran out. So I'll probably what I'll do on this side is maybe, oh no, don't do that. Is maybe knock back this, maybe move these out that way so that we're not, because this is kind of like a main walkway, and I'll probably want my trains to bend off that way. And have some multiple tree farms set up. I mean, we're getting amazing amounts of wood. Now, one thing I noticed was I came over here and these guys were working really slow. The reason is if it fills up with sludge, it'll stop going very fast. So I needed to, wow, hello. Man, you came out of nowhere. I had to set up a sludge boiler to get all that sludge out. And then things started running good again. And then I had to set up this chest so that we could get the outputs of the sludge boiler. And we're getting some interesting stuff, I guess. But we'll have the trains pick this stuff up as well and bring it back. So let's just go back this way. Let's drink some triglycerides and then sprint. All right. Sprint faster. I really need to do some brewing. Maybe if we have any kind of time after this episode, which I doubt, we'll set up a brewing stand. But, I don't think we're gonna have any time left in this episode to do that. This will get us a little bit more track. Oh, we need more stone beds. Okay. So let's see, we need more this. I shouldn't have made that many. Okay, and then let's do this in my inventory because I got this. Oh no, the recipe's gone anyway, never mind. I really wish I could expand the number of recipes that this thing has. That would be awesome. Okay, so that gives us 32 more. We might be able to make it. This guy needs more steel. Before I do that, let's not do that. Let's make our train, because that's the second critical piece. First, you need something for it to run on, then you can do something to actually have it run on there. EAM, steam. There it is. So we're gonna need these guys, which is this stuff, which is good thing I didn't waste my steel ingots. Which is these things. Let's go ahead and make that up. Two, so we need eight. And that makes four, so we're going to need one more. And that's going to take time. Let's see, we need to make these fuel boilers, and we got the. So we need. How many? Two. So we need two fire charges, which I got sitting around here somewhere. And we need those clay bricks. And. Let's see, it's going to go fire charge. Clay bricks, or wait, clay bricks. And I need a bit more cobblestone and that other crafting table. Didn't I? Okay, there it is. And we need two furnaces. And we should have some fireboxes. What can we take out? As you can see, I've got all the pieces here pretty much ready to go for big reactors. I was wondering if you had to go exploring to find those pieces. Seemed a little odd, but you know, maybe that was the drive to get out exploring. Okay, we need to get that other one going. Ah, there we go, just enough power. Okay, so we need... Oh, it made 8. Oh, okay. Well, we have some extra. So we'll go like that. Like that. Like that. And an iron bar. Apparently I'm low on iron bars. Oh, wait. Apparently I'm low on iron bars in every place I've put them. Oh, let's see. Crafting table. Bars. Something's wrong. Oh, high pressure. Steel. Wait. What? Did I make the wrong thing? And now I don't have enough. Oh goody. Fine. Apparently I did make the wrong thing. It happens. Occasionally I make mistakes. Not usually, just occasionally. Quite often, actually. Actually, I don't know if I'm ever right. Let's see. Mine carts. And there's our locomotive. Hooray, electrical. Wait, electrical? I'm using steam. How's that electrical? We need to clear out some inventory space. And my obsidian is behind there. Let's just dump. Steel. We're probably gonna need some. I'm hoping this can be fueled directly by coal. I'm hoping we don't have to produce the steam and feed the steam into it. 'Cause that would be upsetting. Let's see, we have a bunch of charcoal that I've had prepared for my power. And I wonder if I need to go down there and top those guys off. Okay, so if we set this guy down... Oh, we are going to need to... We're going to need to fill it up with water... Okay, so we're gonna need to set up a few things. We're gonna need item loaders and unloaders, and we're gonna need fluid loaders so that we can load this up with charcoal and with water. It's not a very long run, so we should be good. I don't think we'd need to set up another fluid loader on this side. But I could be wrong. Let's see if we've got enough to finish this side off. We still have to finish the other side off, but if we can get one side done, that would be great. Yay, that is great. Alright, so I need to make more track. So how about this? I would like to get this all done this episode, just so we have some working proof of concept. I'll make up the loaders and unloaders that I need and some additional track, and I'll be right back. All right, and we're back. So I think we have everything we need to get this done. So I got an aqueous accumulator set up with water that we can put into it, and I've got a rather substantial amount of water that I can store, but we might need it for other things. So let's see. apparently I left some stuff down. I'm not ready. Oh, and if you glance over yonder, you see those big posts there. I put the wind turbines up there. It's only producing like 80 RF a tick, so it's not as good as I thought it would be, but it's enough to run those harvesters. So we got our locking track that we're gonna need, I think. And yeah, I have some conduit for it. So the basic idea is we're gonna want to detect two things. One, that the cart is empty, and two, that the tank, both the tank and the charcoal are okay, and then we can release the train to continue. So that's what we're gonna do there. And I have no clue why. Well, I know why. We need to put the unloader here. So here's the item unloader. And let's see, let's set down this guy here and the mine cart. Oh, track. I need a piece of track. Now I'm just kind of assuming that this is all how you do it. I think you need to crowbar these. Did that just switch what direction it's going? Okay. Did that hook it together? Whoa. Ah, the gravity. Every time. And I bet you that destroyed the cart. Yeah, if something falls on something else, it destroys it. So, that's so annoying. All right, well, I got another cart down here. So yeah, be careful. If you have items and then gravity drops a block on it, they go bye-bye. Let's see. Oh, I see it. There it is. Never mind. All right, so let's see if we can take two on this. And now that we've got a block under there, let's put our unloader. Can I move you forward just a bit? No. Probably because it's locked. So let's put that guy there. Now let's see if we can get. I think there's a. You have to. Whoops. No, you don't. Okay. That looked like it got. That looked like it worked. Okay. So let's see if we can move these guys forward any. Or maybe it didn't work. Link failed. Link started. Link created. Ha. Now you guys are linked. Okay, so we're going to need to fill this up a little bit so that we can get her moving. Well, let's fill it up as much as possible. Can I? Oh, I can. Good. Okay, that's good enough, but now I don't have any charcoal, of course. Could also use real raw wood on it. That'd probably work just as well. Then technically we could fill her up over there too. Here we go. Mwah. So, now what? Aha. Go. Unleash your fury, my mighty rail car, train, steam guy. Yeah, I don't know what's going on. Okay, so theoretically it should start going once we get enough steam in here. Wow, that burns that pretty quick. I think it does burn through it pretty quick just to get going. Aha! Now you're locked. Man, this is gonna just keep burning through that. Do we have anything else? That might, turn off the train or something? Let's see, detectors. Detector train. Detector locomotive. I wonder if there's any way to toggle this guy. All right, so that's up to cruising speed. This should actually slow down now that once this gets up to temperature, which it looks like it's close to. So let's just go ahead and keep going here. So we want to be able to load the train with fluids. So let's see if we can do that. Okay. I have no clue if this is how you're supposed to do this or not. But that looked like it worked. Whoa! Oh, that emitted a redstone signal and had that go. Well. Yeah. Bon voyage, I suppose. Yeah, we don't want that redstone signal to hit this until it's full. So what we might want to do is have two locking tracks. Whoa! Whoa! Where did you come from? Okay, what's going wrong here? Did it really go that fast? The trains are coming. Man, that thing books. Oh, that's cool. Oh, I like it. That is neat. All right, well, we gotta finish it. We need to be able to put things on and take things off. So, let's see. I wonder if this is the wrong way. I wonder if we need this to be off powered. Is there an inverted? Is it a holding track? No, it's advanced. No, it's not. What is it? Locking track, that's what we want. You're gonna run out of power, little guy. Hit with a crowbar to change modes. Okay. Change to train lockdown mode, holding mode, train holding mode, boarding mode. Aha. Okay, so he's stopped now. And we're completely out of coal. Okay, well let's just have him hold there for a second. So here's where we're gonna load the liquid, and once that's full, we want to block him. We'll block him here. And we'll do train holding mode, train lockdown mode, and that will allow this cart to stop on top of this and unload. So then we need a detector item. Empty. And if it's empty, we want to do some sort of thing. I think emit a redstone signal. And we need a detector tank on this guy, not there. Can I actually get back there? like that. Okay. So we want to detect if this tank is 100%, I suppose. And I guess we could filter that to only water if I had my buckets. And we might want to put another item detector on the other side to check if it's check if the coal box is full. Just kind of eyeing this up, it looks a little odd. Oh well, let's run fluid conduit and extract. Always active. Okay, so there we go. That worked. Now this should be emitting a redstone signal, I think. Do I have to force the connection? It looks like it's emitting. Am I gonna get run over? Okay, so no. So this worked well. It released it when it was full. And now we have it stopped here. If we switched this around so that this was the fluid and this was the empty. Maybe if we do. Maybe if we do something like this. Ah, geez, which way is that? That's east. So I think that looks like it's emitting redstone. Nothing's happening. Okay. So that one worked well. What's wrong with this one? You know what? I wonder if it's not far enough forward to detect. Let's Oh, I see. It's locked here. Okay, we have to move this forward a bit. That's not the one I wanted to unlock, huh? Well, what do I have? I need a lever. This episode's probably out of time right now, but let's see if we can at least get the logistics here sorted. And I'd hate to waste more charcoal trying to figure this out, but you gotta do what you gotta do. So I wonder if we locked the cart, if that would stop. Yeah, I think it might, actually. Maybe we can do that. Okay, so there we go. Let's hold this guy back here, because he's going to keep circling. Train lockdown mode. So, how do we want to do this? So this worked well for locking that to wait for the thing to get full. What? Go away. So now we want to do the items. Let's do something like that. Empty, and let's put the lockdown. I guess it has to be here. I don't think it matters the way we were doing that. Okay. Well, then this is in the wrong spot. Oh, it emptied the. Oh. That's why there was nothing in there. It emptied the train. Okay. Well, we'll have to fix that. Where'd it go? There it is. Number two. Unload. Let's put that track back over here. Is there filters? I Move items until the destination matches filter. Keep items in the filter, move the rest. Move all matching items. So we only want to filter carts. We don't want to do the train. And I wonder if it ran out of steam somewhere. Do I have another mine cart with chest? Let's see if this works. Because we don't want it to read the locomotive. Yeah, okay, so hopefully that works. We want to all. And that should work. And then that will emit a redstone signal. Ah. Nope, stop that. Detector, so if it's empty, yeah. Then we'll go like this. Does it matter which side? All right, well, now all I need is that train back. So if that's empty, that's going to work. Then we need to stop our train here. Put that down. Put that down. And now this one was working. But we also need an item loader to put our charcoals in. So we need fluid loader. See, now I wonder if we need the advanced one. I wonder if you can do from the side too on the advanced. Because now we need another item loader. We need another item detector. And this is going to cut into my stuff for the other side. Another locking. Filtered, not empty, analog, empty, full of. At least, at most, exactly, less than, greater than.64. So that should theoretically block him here to fill up on coal. And then we'll have to run that somewhere. So the only question is this piece going to work here, the unloading? Let's go find our wayward. I wonder if it, watch, it probably blew up in the tunnel and took out half my base. Doo-doo-doo. He's definitely stopped. This would be a bad idea if it was coming back. I don't know if those things can kill you. There you are. What are you done? What are you out of? You're out of coal. Okie dokie. Let me load you. Oh, hey. Oh, hey. You can store a lot more in there. I'm gonna have to rearrange that filter, I think. I'm also gonna have to, if we can get a blaze farm going, we could change this. I wonder if you slow it down, if it's more fuel efficient. Because it was going pretty fast. Let's go kind of medium, I guess. Okay, we need to get back over there quick. And that's looking pretty nice, actually. So here we are. Hopefully this all works. They're going to be coming soon, and I need to get rid of this. All right, so train should come here, put the cart over top of this. This should detect empty, release it. Locomotive will come here. Okay, so that's definitely detecting empty. Come on now. Don't do this to me. East. Oh, stop that. Well, we could old fashion this. Let's do this one last thing here. Let's try just a piece of redstone. That would be the most operable way to do it, I suppose. And pop him there. Okay, apparently not. Where's my lever? Let's release him manually. And he blew past here. Oh, there was exactly 64. Okay, well, that's exactly what we asked for. So there's just this one piece here. Getting this guy to unlock. Because I don't think you could set it over here and have that work. Okay, well, I'll have to figure that out, what's wrong with this piece. But I think we got everything we need. Basically, all I have to do now is set up the item loader over on that side to load in the wood and bring it back here. Yeah. That's disappointing. Because it doesn't look like this is connecting, unless like the only place it can output a signal to is the top. Or maybe the front is where it emits the signal. Am I missing a rail, maybe? Because it would seem like we'd want like a applies a small omnidirectional boost. Apply redstone to enable. Whistle track, limiter track. It seems like there should be a track that transmits a redstone signal. All right, well, I'll have to look into that and see what I'm missing here. But, yeah, go ahead and leave a like or subscribe, and have a good one, guys.